Hey guys, welcome back to This Bytes For You. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to build a budget PC, not only a budget PC, but a budget PC that's actually going to be able to play the latest and the greatest games at 1920 by 1080, some even at 1440p. I have a full list in the description below of all the parts in the system in case you guys want to check it out. But anyway, let's stop wasting time and let's get to the build. All right, so the motherboard we're using in this build is the Asus ROG Strix B550-F Gaming Wi-Fi Edition. Now, this board costs a little bit more than the other boards, but the reason I chose this board, aside from it being a great board, is because it gives you the opportunity, the ability to update to AMD's latest and greatest, maybe when you have a little more cash on you. Now, the CPU I chose is the AMD Ryzen 5 3600. This is a great processor as it is right now, a 6-core 12-thread processor. So chances are you're not going to need to upgrade if anytime soon at all, but just in case you wanted to, you have the ability to. So we're going to be installing the CPU first. First thing you're going to want to do is raise this little arm up there, just releasing the socket so you can actually install the CPU. So you'll notice right over here on the processor, there is a little gold pin. It's kind of hard to see. That gold pin is going to match up with this little pin down here. You might be able to see it. Let me zoom in a little bit more. This right there, that way you know that that is where that is going to line up. So you can just literally drop it into place. There is no force you need to use whatsoever to get that in place. If you're pushing down really hard, it's either in the wrong location or you have a bent pin. Make sure you check it first. So that you have a better view of things, I'm just zooming in a little bit closer. Again, we're going to line up that gold pin right along here. Match up the pinholes. Might take a few tries to get it perfect. And when it's good, it literally just falls into place. You don't need to push down. And then lower the arm. And that locks the CPU in place. So now we need to install the heatsink or the liquid cooling unit. But in this case, we're installing the heatsink that the CPU brings. Okay, so one thing to note is if you notice right along there, it already has its own thermal paste pre-applied. Some people think it's not good and wipe it off and use their own thermal paste. But if I use thermal paste, I need to add a few more bucks to the build and I want to keep it as affordable as possible. Okay, so you'll notice that you have to screw these in, but there is no hole to do that. We're going to need to remove these two right over here. The purpose for these two is for those heat sinks that'll go on and then just kind of clamp right over here, but that's not the way this one works. So let's just go ahead and unscrew that. Just lift that off. Then you'll notice now you have the screw holes. Okay, and just take this off. Okay, I do recommend keeping all the screws and these in a separate bag. Keep it in the motherboard box. That way you don't lose them. You may need them later and you don't want to have to find some way of buying these again. Okay, and because I want to keep everything looking nice, notice how the ROG Strix is written that way. I want to keep the AMD text facing that way as well. Unfortunately, I can't install it that way. And so now you'll notice the screws line up right over here. So we're just gonna kind of drop it in place for right now. Now that we know everything's in place, just wiggle it around just to make sure no screws fall out and just screw one over here, this one down, about 50% each. And then we'll come over here, screw this one down 50% and then this one down 50%. Okay, now when all of them are screwed down 50%, just go ahead and screw them all down. Okay, now that that one's screwed down all the way, we'll go ahead and screw the rest down nice and tight. Just the same way, just in reverse. All right, now with that screwed in, we'll go ahead and plug in the fan to the motherboard. We'll do that right down over here. Okay, and it's silk screened over here, but it pertains to these over here. This is CPU fan, and this is CPU fan optional. So we'll go ahead and plug it in to CPU fan. Okay, now just make sure when you plug it in that you see these two little ridges along the side, that they go over this plastic piece over here. That's the way you know you have it installed correctly. And we'll rearrange the cables later on during the cabling portion. All right, now that we have the CPU in, we're going to be installing the RAM. So when you have two sticks of RAM, you're going to be installing it in DIMM B2 and DIMM A2. Make sure to check with the manual always when you're installing RAM, but you can find out exactly where that is. You can see what the DIMMs are designated with a little silk screening right over here. Let me zoom you in. Okay, and this silk screening tells you first one is B1, second one is B2, third is A1, and fourth is A2. So bringing you down to the RAM, as we know this is B2 and this is A2. In order to get RAM in here, first we need to push these open. That just releases the DIMM slot so that you could put RAM in there. Now you'll notice there's a little notch right over here on the board, and that's going to go ahead and align with the notch right here on the RAM. So putting it this way, you'll notice it won't work. The memory will just kind of seesaw there. So we just take it out, flip it around, and then because you'll notice there's nothing here to unlock the memory is gonna go in first on this side in the little slot, and then it'll go in here so that the memory locks in place. You notice when I push down, that clamped the memory in place, locking the memory. So again, turn it around, slide it down here. And then just push down lightly. All right, so we've just installed the CPU and installed RAM. Awesome. So let's move on to the M.2 SSDs. The M.2 sockets are hidden right now. There's a heatsink right here and a heatsink right here. The M.2 is going to go underneath of that. So in order to release that, we'll just go ahead and unscrew that M.2 heatsink. All right, there is also film under here that we will need to release in a second, but I'll show you how to do that in one sec. All right, both of these M.2 SSDs are 2280 form factor, and the box will tell you, but right over here, you'll notice there's silk screening for 22110, 2280, 2260 and 2242. But again, we need to worry about 2280. So what we're going to do, these little screws come in the motherboard box. So first off, we're going to be screwing in the standoff right into the 2280 standoff location here. Now, you don't need to put those in very hard. You can use the force from your fingertips. And then you'll notice there is also a thermal pad right over here. And I'll go ahead and do that up here under the 2280. Since I've already shown you close up. Okay, and then we're going to use the other little screw to screw in the M.2. So I'm gonna show you real quick how to install it here. And then I'll show you in more detail down here. All right, that one's installed. And I'm going to go ahead and install the heatsink as well. So with your fingernail, just go ahead and take off that film. Okay, now you're going to leave this piece there. That's going to help cool the M.2 down. And then when you have it, just push down on the heatsink a little tiny bit, just to make sure that makes contact. And go ahead and screw that heatsink in. All right, let me show you a little bit closer down here. So this is an NVMe drive, and we're going to be plugging it in right over here. So literally all you do is slide it right into that little slot, push it in a little tiny bit, and that's it. If it hovers like that, it's installed, or at least plugged in. So now all we do is grab that screw and screw it in. It's incredibly easy, but I know it can be overwhelming. So we'll just take off this film again and go ahead and line those up. Pushing down a little bit on here. All right, so now we've just installed the second M.2 SSD. Now the reason I have two in here is this one is going to be for Windows, and then this one is going to be for games or whatever other applications. They're both 500 gigs. You can use, of course, whatever size you want. If you had a regular SATA drive, one that wasn't an M.2 drive, you would plug those in right over here. This board has six SATA 6 gigabit per second ports. All right, so at this point, we're ready to install the motherboard into the case. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and install the motherboard into the case. There's one very important thing you need to remember when doing this. On the motherboard, there is a screw here, screw hole here, 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 and here. Nine screw holes. So inside of the case, you'll notice there's a standoff here, here. There's one missing here. We need to fill that one in. Then there's one here, one here. There's another one missing right over here. Then there's one down here, and another one missing down here. We're going to go ahead and need to install standoffs. The case brings a few additional standoffs, and they also bring this great little tool that helps a ton. That way you don't need needleless pliers. So what you do is you grab your screwdriver, and you'll notice there's a Phillips head right there. We'll just lay that right here. And we'll go ahead and put a standoff right into there. And then we'll just screw that into place. Now you don't want to screw it in too hard, but you want to screw it in hard enough that it's not going to go anywhere. You don't want to screw it in too hard because then you'll thread it and then it'll be loose. And then if you go to take off the motherboard at some point later on, you'll just have that screw spinning there forever. So just putting one in the center over here. And last but not least, right down here. Now, normally you would have to install an IO shield here that would come separately in the motherboard box. But as you can see, this motherboard already has it plugged in, which is pretty awesome. Definitely a time saver. I'm going to go ahead and just rest the motherboard here for now. Now, normally you would install this with the case laying down. It's a lot easier, but since I'm recording, I like to do it standing up. That way you can see everything I'm doing. All right, so the case brings 21 of these screws, these little screws here. And those are going to be the screws that we use to put the motherboard in place. Okay, so I'm going to start over here. Just move these fan cables out of the way. Now, before you start screwing in anything, make sure all 9 of the screw holes line up with the standoffs, and just go ahead and screw one in. Not 100%, maybe 80%. Okay. And now that you know that one's in place, and now we'll go ahead and install one down here on the far left-hand corner. That way we know that everything is lined up correctly. And with this screw, since now you know everything's lined up correctly, you can screw that one in 100%. And then come back and screw this one in 100%. So now I'm going to screw in the rest of the screws real quick. Okay, so now we're going to install the video card. Chances are though, I'm going to need to remove it later on to install some of the cabling, but that's okay. I just want to show you how to do that real quick. For the video card, we're going to go ahead and remove this slot cover and this slot cover, the second and the third. So we'll just grab our screwdriver again. Take that out. And take care of the third one real quick. Now for these, I always recommend keep them in the motherboard box. That way, in case you're going to get a different video card or something along those lines, you always have it for later on. Don't throw them away. Okay, now to install the video card, we're going to be installing it onto the first PCIe by 16 slot. And we're going to be matching up these fingers right over here with this right over here, this slot. And then, of course, coming through here. Okay, now with the card in place, you'll notice this little guy is going to go pop out. That just locks the card in place. Okay, it moved a little tiny bit, not a whole lot, but that locks the card in place. That way you can't just pull it out. And then now we'll go ahead and screw these back in over here. That took a lot less time than it normally does. So that's pretty awesome. We've gotten through the hardware portion of the build. The next step, the next video, is the wiring portion of the build. Arguably one of the most time-consuming parts about building a PC. I've shown you how to install the motherboard, the RAM, the CPU, the heatsink, and the video card. All pretty simple, right? Inside of the Montec case, which so far looks like an awesome case. The fact that Asus has that IO shield integrated to the back of the board already, so there's no way you can forget it. It's pretty genius of them. So you can see it just slid right in. There was no snapping or anything I needed to do. The video card already installed. Now we just need to worry about the power supply and the cabling. So let me know down in the comments below, was it easy for you? Was it difficult? Was there a step I missed that I should have taken? Aside from laying the case down on its side, which makes it easy to build, just hard for me to record. But as always, please do click like and subscribe and the little bell notification. The like and the subscribe really does help me out. That way I can bring you many more videos like this and even bigger and better ones in the future. The notification, of course, is so that when I come out with videos, you guys know immediately. Let's move on over to the wiring portion of this series.